Hey, welcome to Sweaty Video Game Nerds. I'm Jon Schnepp. I'm sitting here with the video game mistress of the madness, Maude Garrett. Welcome to the show.
Wow, thanks for the intro.
Hey, today we are going to talk about an incredible Batman game called Batman Arkham Asylum and all its later iterations. But I just want to start off by talking about how incredible they finally captured Batman. Like, playing this game is the first time I ever felt like my giant fat self was Batman, hanging upside down, beating on criminals. It's just literally they captured what it would feel like to play Batman in the comfort of your own home with no actual real danger. So
yeah.
Let's talk about Batman Arkham Asylum.
You are so right. They completely take over Gotham in this one, and they do such a great job because it is dark and gritty. And I think a big reason why they've nailed it is because it was written by Paul Dini, who did a lot of the comics. So he knows the Batman universe better than most people. So he was able to capture that so well. You do see a lot of familiar faces in this one. You get to know the Joker a lot better. You see the origins of Harley Quinn. You do go into the asylum, which is not only scary, but filled with great adventure at the same time. Kevin Conroy is voicing Batman, and he's one of the best voices of Batman I've come across. I thought he is great in it. But what's awesome is Mark Hamill is Joker.
Yeah.
Like, that is your nerd sweat right there. That is just like, look at that. That's just when you're just playing controllers and you realize it's moist because there's just seeping out everywhere. But because this game was so successful, in fact, it has a Guinness World Record for being the most critically acclaimed superhero game out there. So we've seen so many more games from Batman since, like Batman Arkham City.
Right, where you actually are outside of the asylum. But like the actual asylum, some of the sequences when he was fighting Scarecrow,
yeah,
those are really freaky, like weird and very hard to get past.
Yeah.
Weird, different strategy style. It's not just third person. You're like scrolling across this giant nightmare city. I wanted to also mention that not only Mark Hamill, but Kevin Conroy and Paul Dini are all from the animated series of Batman. So they did a great service of bringing over what was a great iteration of Batman, the animated series, and then bringing it into this incredible 3D world, this video game. Like Arkham City, I played a little bit of it. I haven't gotten through it. So what were your take on Arkham City?
This is more about Catwoman this time around. Like, there's a side plot there, which I thought was really great. You know, you've just seen Arkham Asylum and you know, you're just going on from what happened there. Funny, I didn't finish Arkham Asylum. I was too busy going straight to City. That's what I wanted to do. But like you say, it's so open world and you were able to access all parts of it. So you've got your grappling hook and your batarang, everything, you know, you're able to be fully immersive. But it's funny that you mentioned the fighting style, because that's what was unique with these games. Mm. You know, you can button mash if you want to, but you have to be really kind of smart about the button play.
Right.
And you're able to unlock different ways that you can battle. And
yeah.
So it'll kind of be like, hey, you've just learnt to use, you know, other things in your environment. Maybe you want to pick up that big barrel there and throw it at your enemy.
And it's like, very satisfying too. Yeah. The graphic, they're like, hey, I just smashed that guy in the face with my knee.
Yeah,
I just,
well, there's nothing worse than, you know, having a long game, like 20 hours more, and just doing the same thing over and over again. It's like, as a gamer, you kind of want to be able to do more with this, and they give it straight to you.
So you got a chance to play Arkham Knight.
Yes. Well, I went to Montreal, actually, to test out Batman Origins, which is 5 years before Arkham Asylum. So this is a younger Batman.
Mm-hmm.
But they had Craig Smith voicing Batman this time to be younger and have that more of a youthful sound. Really like Roger. Unfortunately, the game didn't go so well.
Wow.
I'm not sure if it was because they realized that they had a good thing going, so they wanted to do it quite quickly. But what was really cool going behind the scenes there at the mocap studio is that they used the exact same camera that James Cameron used for Avatar.
Wow.
So like that whole mocap where when you look into the display there, the whole world was already in it. And the actors in their mocap gear became like the character on the screen.
Wow.
Like in real time. That's like mind-blowing.
I mean, it's really incredible. Just the animated capture scenes that they've done, the movie, it's like cinematic.
Yeah.
It's incredible, all the scenes that they've shown online. And when you're playing the game, when you have those in-game cinematics, they've just like, it's literally like you're watching a movie.
Yeah.
It's very satisfying.
And then it's like, all right, now play it. Now play as this character. You're
so,
like, okay, Gotham needs me.
If you guys have not played Arkham Asylum or Arkham City or Arkham Knight, you owe it to yourself to become Batman for 1 to 40 days, however long it takes you to get totally immersed. I want to wrap this one up and say, Maude, where can people find you online?
If you search Maude Garrett on anything social media, you'll find me. But if you want to catch more Geek Bomb, jump onto geekbomb.net.
Awesome. And I will see you guys later in the sweaty video game nerd realm. For more of the Sweaty Nerd Show, just subscribe at the bottom there to theStreamtv and you can check out Get More Sweat.